Any advice for people, must be one person out there like me, that finds themselves, you know, kind of giving up their life for their children because of either guilt or not knowing kind of the right way to parent and self-care? Any tips you might give someone like me on what to do?
Yeah, so I do think that you're sort of onto it, that if you're martyring, your kids are going to feel it, number one. Two, you're not role modeling well. If you sacrifice your entire identity, your own identity, your own hobbies or passions or your adult relationships for your kids, not only are you unhappy and you're sort of operating on fumes, but your kids feel a lot of pressure. And they're like, oh, that looks like miserable to be an adult. All you're doing is working all the time. Yeah. You're not having any fun. You don't have any hobbies. And it's also a lot of pressure for them if you are their entire life, because that makes it hard for kids to leave and grow up and launch. They're like, oh my God, when I leave, my dad, my mom, they're going to have nothing because I'm their everything. So the key, so really recognize your role modeling. You're going to be a happier parent. You're going to be a more creative parent. You're going to bring a lot more to the table. That's to change the mindset. And then you want to, once the mindset is there and you believe this, then you want to change the mechanics. I think we make a huge error as parents. And once we have kids, we never change our approach to self-care. And we keep trying to do it the way we did it before we had kids, in big blocks of time. So we think of exercise as that's 90 minutes, three times a week at a gym. And we think of our marriages and our friendships as long date nights or big blocks of big, huge ski trips, you know, every 6 weeks. And we don't have the big blocks of time once you're a parent. So we just abandon all self-care. But what if you changed your mechanical approach and you started building self-care in small doses, delivered consistently, right? Hanging out with a friend, maybe not for an entire ski trip every week, every month, but you get together, you invite them over and you have families come over and you guys all hang out, the kids hang out and the adults hang out, or you go out for a 20-minute walk or a half an hour walk, or you and your spouse don't need to go on date night if after the kids go to sleep, you spend 30 minutes not talking logistics, not talking about your work day, but just really catching up with each other.